The Minute, A380, Episode 8. The Airbus A380 has a very particular and complex fuel system due to the extraordinary dimensions of the aircraft, designed for ultra-long-haul flights with a range of approximately 8,000 nautical miles. This video is going to be an overview of the system, as entering into details would require several episodes and would interest only professionals, so let's make it short. The fuel system stores fuel, monitors the fuel quantity in each tank, and controls the fuel transfer to supply the engines and the APU to maintain the center of gravity, CG, within limits, to alleviate the structural loads, to control refueling and defueling, and to enable fuel jettison if necessary. This whole operation is automatically controlled and monitored on ground and during a flight via two fuel quantity and management system, FQMS. The total usable fuel is approximately 254 tons based on the specific fuel density of 0.785 kg per liter. All this fuel is stored in the wings and in the trimmable horizontal stabilizer, THS. The fuel is distributed into 11 tanks, 5 in each wing and 1 trim tank in the THS. Each wing has an outer, a mid, an inner tank, and 2 feed tanks, 1 for each engine. The A380 fuel system is considered as having 2 independent systems, the engine APU fuel feed system and the fuel transfer system. Each feed tank has 2 pumps, a main pump which runs continuously to feed its assigned engine, and a standby pump which starts in case the main pump is faulty or switched off. The fuel pumps can supply the fuel to all the engines using the cross-feed system. Basically, if any main or standby pump from any feed tank are off, any other main or standby pump from any other feed tank would supply the related engine. And if all the fuel pumps fail during your flight, it is not your lucky day, but relax, it's not a max. You are still in an Airbus, and fuel can be fed to the engines by gravity. The APU is normally fed by the main pump in feed tank 4, but it can be fed by any main or standby pump or by the APU feed pump. Okay, I know all these details might be a bit complicated, so let's talk practicality. Let's see how pilots use this system during a flight. The fuel that pilots manage during a flight is divided as taxi fuel, trip fuel, contingency fuel, alternate fuel, and final reserve fuel. And all this fuel added up together gives us the ramp fuel, which is the total fuel. Now, two questions for you. For an IFR flight, what is the minimum contingency fuel and what is the legal final reserve? On ground, pilots receive a flight plan provided by the company with the minimum fuel for this flight. Pilots then decide to add fuel or not, depending on the conditions of the day. They check the weather, the NOTAMs at departure, en route alternate, arrival, and arrival alternate airports. The pilot's experience play a key role in this phase, and trust me, I have seen captains thinking of variables my modest experience wouldn't allow me to see. During cruise and approximately every 30 minutes, pilots check that the sum of the fuel on board plus the fuel used is consistent with the fuel at departure. If this sum decreases, a fuel leak can be suspected. And if a fuel leak is suspected, an abnormal ECAM procedure fuel leak detected can be carried out. Also, pilots compare between the actual fuel on the FMS at certain waypoints and the fuel prediction at these same waypoints but on the flight plan. Now imagine with me this scenario. We fly from Sydney, Australia to Doha, Qatar. We roughly need 220 tons of fuel for this sector. We take off from Sydney at maximum takeoff weight 573 tons. A failure after takeoff forces us to go back to Sydney Airport. The problem is, we are 180 tons above the maximum landing weight of 393 tons. And I know you know those numbers because you have watched the Minute A380 Episode 3 and 4 Limitations. Our first option would be to jettison the fuel, which we do, but the problem, the fuel in the feed tanks of the Airbus A380 cannot be jettisoned. so we might be overweight even after fuel jettison. Then we carry out the overweight landing checklist and we land safely into Sydney. Thank you very much for flying with me. See you soon. Cheers.